So the Benchmade tagged out 15,535 CPM 154 Hunt series, so they say. Yola. So I figured for this video, these were probably the most relevant comparisons. I don't have a bug out. I got this bailout. So I guess this one bailed out, and this one got tagged out. I'm kidding. All right, so it's a hunting knife called the Tagged Out. I just got it. I haven't even cut anything with it. But I just couldn't help myself. I think that it's overpriced. But I don't know if anybody else out there makes anything close to this. So I'll read through the specs. And I couldn't help myself because I'm a big 154 CM fan. So this supposedly is the upgrade, CPM 154. The particle steel, crucible, particle metallurgy, for whatever that means. All right, so dimensions on this bad boy, 8 1/13 hundredths overall, blade length of 3.5. I guess I could throw that up there. People should be very familiar with the old Griptilian. It actually is longer than the Griptilian. I have this piece of paper here to reduce the glare from the light. And I'm actually using the flash on my camera too for a few things. Blade thickness of 9 hundredths. So it is thin. I actually measured. I measured it somewhere. Mine only goes up to hundredths. It was almost 9. So it's 80 something hundredths. Or 80 something thousandths. 85 thousandths, I'd say. CPM 154, like I said, weight of 2.1 ounces, so it's extremely light. And I think those bug outs were 1.8, so this is 2.1, so 3/10 of an ounce heavier for this, but it's extremely light. It's actually lighter than this. Actually, you can actually tell a difference. Actually. Handle thickness, what did I come up with? I think it's like 4/10, somewhere under 4/10. In my opinion, the only thing that really matters to that is like right here, because if that width, you know, is on your hand, that's like the important part. So it's actually under what they advertised at. I think it was like, I think they say it's 4/900 or so, but that's probably in the middle. So up here, where your hand actually contacts it, you know, the back of your hand, it's a little thinner than that. Kind of like all of them. They're all like that. That's obviously the fattest one. And this one, I think, is actually thinner. I wish I would have written that down. Okay. So with the bailout here, an M4 steel, 8.7 overall, so it's a little shorter. The blade is 3.4 inches, a little shorter. Blade thickness, 9 hundredths, so it's about the same. M4 for the steel, so you can consider that an upgrade, except for this is more stainless. This is definitely better for, you know, game. And 2.7 ounces, so theoretically half ounce heavier. And you can feel it. This is really light, but this is like air light. And the Griptilian, I figured I'd throw in the relative specs for that. 3.45 inches for the blade length, and which has actually, it's pretty comparable. It's close. This one actually, you can definitely visually tell that the, I'm on my, see if I can get that kind of lined up there. This one is longer. Seems like almost like 1/8 of an inch longer. 3.82 ounces, so almost 4 ounces, so almost 2 ounces heavier. I mean, it's a, that's, you know, it's a pretty lightweight knife. kind of a more, honestly, more hard use knife. Keep that in mind. Like I said, I haven't gotten out and really used this yet. I just got it today. This one's been used quite a bit and used as hard as I would normally use a folding knife. Lots of torque put on it, no impact. And blade thickness, I think this was, 1100s maybe. Or I should say 11,000s. No, 1100s. Somewhere in that range. So a little thicker blade, a little different blade grind. I think that they claim this one is thinner. You know, it's a thinner blade grind, which I believe. I mean, it is like a scalpel. It's very thin, and it definitely comes down. I think they're advertising they have this at a 14 degree per side. I don't know yet until I put it on my sharp maker. I think that's about right, though. So, yeah. But anyway, for anybody, I would say, myself included, that really wasn't really into that whole bug out thing, that blade shape or the whole thing, somehow this one worked on me. I am a hunter, and I'm telling you, I don't understand, if you're using something that is going to get bloody, hopefully not guts, that's not the idea, you don't want to be cutting guts, but blood, fur, feathers, maybe fish guts, I guess. Why did they do this on the inside? I know it's for like stability. Actually, I haven't got a chance to check this. It's a little flexible. Not bad, though. You know, this one doesn't have any flex to it. Of course, these are rock solid. Anyway, you can see in there like this like waffle cone cutout deal they got in here. Speaking of waffles, I am staying at a hotel off a day off, and I'm going to have waffles in the morning for breakfast. But they do that, and it just seems like everything you're cutting, blood, whatnot, is going to get stuck in there. Yeah. So it's kind of odd. I think, let's look at the inside of this one. It's smooth. There's like a little cutout in there, though, but it's generally smooth. Probably a lot easier to clean this. I never have, but it's probably a lot easier to clean that. There's a pocket lint there. Probably see that. Yeah. This one really hasn't attracted a whole lot, but I haven't used this for hunting at all. It's got some food. I'm pretty careful about it. I guess most of your cutting, small game at least, will be out here. Keep it out of the mechanism as best you can. But let's get to the positives here. I guess I'll do the good, the bad, and the ugly, and all that. The good, I would say, is the weight, blade shape, and cutting ability. Like I said, I've cut some paper, I think I cut a piece of paper with it, or a receipt. Probably cut the receipt that came with it. It's extremely sharp. So I'm assuming it's a really good slicer. Great. And that's one thing I like about this knife. So low profile, so lightweight, you don't even know it's in your pocket. Negative on that is I don't understand why they got that on there, But they do. This one doesn't. It's a little fatter. I think it's a light knife. It's a little chunkier in the pocket. No big deal. So good knife as well. But this one, that, and it's got some chimping on it. So I'd say that's a positive. I'm glad it doesn't have thumb studs, because this is a hunting knife. You don't need it to open super quick. It's pretty going to be pretty deliberate on the opening part. It's pretty smooth. Still breaking in, but it's very smooth. It's always nice. I do like that pocket clip. That's a positive. Normally, I don't like deep carry clips, but I do like these small stubby ones. The construction seems bomb-proof. I don't know if this is going to... That centering is absolutely, as usual, picture-perfect. So we're still doing the good. I like the color, honestly. I got no complaints about that. They do have a stone wash on the blade. As you can see. That's cool. It's going to reduce the appearance of wear on it. 154 or CPM 154, I'd say, is a positive, though I haven't even, that's the first knife I believe that it has CPM 154. As I've stated a million times, I do love 154 CM. So if this is an upgrade to that, well, great. I like the hardware. It's black, kind of lukewarm on the backs or these standoff colors of the gold, copper. I mean, you know, whatever. That's one thing. I'm more of a fan of closed. In fact, here, I just got this recently as well. I've heard some people bitching about this one. This should have standoffs. I don't agree. This is that proxy. I'll do a video on that at some point. But Q-tip, very easy to clean out. Cool knife. Been carrying that one. So the Tagged Out, I think this is a good knife for in the field. So let's, okay, we're doing the positives here. So those are all positives. I like the color. Of course, that's subjective. Fit and finish is absolutely flawless. Good choice on the pocket clip, though I don't mind if you had a standard three-hole standard, that would have been fine. But I think with this knife, I think this is definitely adequate. Why not? Plus, if it's, you know, it's designed to be carrying in the bush, deep carry is probably better, optimal, so that it doesn't get snagged by brush, which does happen. Brush, branches, whatnot will snag that. Could rip it out of your pocket, though. I don't know if I've ever had that issue. Definitely possible. That's what always gets me when people put lanyards. It's stupid. Unless you're putting it in your pocket and not clipping it to your pocket, a lanyard is a really dumb idea if you're actually outside in the bush. So those are all the positives. Maybe there's even more. I think the blade grind is definitely a positive. Negative. It is what it is, so I don't think I'm going to be too critical about what it is. The only thing I think is a negative is that. So they probably do it for a reason. It probably lightens it up. It might even make it more sturdy. I don't know. I think that's the idea. But I think it's just makes cleaning it extremely hard unless you take it apart and put those scales in the dishwasher. I mean, if you did get blood and get stuck in there, you could blast it out with a pressure washer, I suppose, take it apart. Anyhow, that's only negative. The rest is all positive. If you're looking at this, I highly recommend it if you're familiar. If you do order it and you're not really, you don't know really what to expect, well, you're going to get it in the mail or you're going to go pick it up and it's going to be extremely lightweight. So maybe you should go to a shop like I did and check it out before you buy it. I kind of went in there knowing I was going to buy it though. So I'll be carrying it here for the next 2 weeks. I've been carrying, of course, my FO, but then pretty much all summer I have that Auto Adamus. I love that thing. So I'll take that too, but I'm going to try to give this as much use as possible. Maybe I'll do another long-term review on it. It's got some chipping here. That's one benefit, I think, over this. I've never liked the chipping that they've put here, and here. So this one, it's got some structure, texture on the scale sides, which is nice. I mean, it is. I do like that. And otherwise, it's got no stupid-ass jimping back here, just a little bit right here, and it's actually probably less sharp than on the Griptilian. And that's the only negative thing about this Griptilian is the jimping they put on there. I think is unnecessary. I don't mind this stuff. That's fine. Traction on the sides. I've never been a real fan. I don't mind that, I guess. I don't like this or this. But it seems like the Griptilian's kind of going away. They only offer it, I think, kind of in one or two colors now, and it's just a drop point. No more sheep's foot. So maybe it's going away, which would be a bummer because I really think this is a great knife. I mean, it's been their bread and butter for years. And then comparing it to this, you know, I like this knife too. I like the aluminum. I like the color. I like the blade steel. I like the blade shape, the Tonto. But I'd say this is preferable. So hopefully down the road, and I don't even know if it's even necessary. If they did, I can kind of guarantee that if they did put aluminum scale on this, handle on this, I would go for it. I guess another negative is subjective. I think, it's not really subjective, but if they could smooth out the inside of those scales and then have a back spacer in here or just do what they did with this, I'd like it. Some of the videos I watched on Benchmade knives, though, and people talking, I think generally the population likes these standoffs, and I don't, because in your pocket stuff can get in there and chip up your blade. Keys, coins, I don't know, a paper clip, anything can get in there. I just don't think that's a good idea. I know it reduces weight, and maybe you could say it's easier to clean out. I just don't think so, because like I said previously, not this knife necessarily, but there again, with the proxy, the Q-tip. Now this is new because this is a new knife. Okay. I've been carrying it here on my 2 days off, but it doesn't have any gunk in there, pocket lint or anything. But if it did, it'd be very easy to clean it out with a toothpick. That's what I've always appreciated about that AFO I have. Right. Well, I think I'll cut it off right there. Hopefully this was informative. You all have a good day, evening.